Now, Milarepa, disciple of Mapa the Great. Yes. Mapa, master told him not to go anywhere. Go hide, okay? Don't go down the mountain. Don't go near people. Don't teach anybody. If you want to keep your life intact and your spiritual unhindered, don't go near humans. Therefore, he stayed all the way there. But then some people will even discover him. And then sometimes he went down and he taught them something. Maybe he did not go down, but he taught them something. There were four nuns who came and learned with him and asked him to go back to their village so he could teach other people. He said, no, I am here. It's good for me. I don't want to go down. But then still some people became his followers and so-called disciples. One of them, very, very envious of his fame and all the respect that the people gave to Milarepa. He poisoned the master, Milarepa. I think poison, right? Huh? I think so, yes. A long time already since I read this. Long. Well, at least 30-some years ago, when I still had time to read, you know? Like in India or whatever, yes. And now I don't have time to even read my own mind, what I want this morning or not. Ah, God, if you sit next to me, you will complain also, like my dog the other day. I have time, no time for dogs. I have no time for myself even. Thank God you come every week so I take a shower, you know, and smell nice, yeah, and wear new clothes. If not, I'm very comfortable with whatever, okay? No time for thinking even, yeah? Now, one of Milarepa's disciples, a man who was very envious, jealous of him, poisoned him. And then the master, Jesu Milarepa, was in agony, of course. In those times, maybe they're so wicked, they gave him the poison that won't kill immediately, but he had to agonize for a long time before he died. And then he came. Because of other disciples around, you know, concerned. And he also pretended to be concerned. He said, oh, Master, why don't you give me all your pain so that you will be relieved? Yeah. He poisoned him and then pretended to be kind to the Master. So the Master said, no, you could not bear it. Such a pain, you could not bear it. I can, because maybe I have a little power. Thanks to my master, Mapa, but you could not bear it. So he still insisted, please, Master, please give all the suffering to me so that you will be free. Blah, 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 blah. And because Milarepa had some magical power and as habit, will have it. If you have miracle power, you cannot not use it, good or bad. Yeah. Therefore, I say to you, if you have magical power, forget that you have it. Don't use it. Otherwise, it continues a habit. And this is just like borrowing from this physical and the astral world. You have to pay dearly, yeah? At the end, or it will cut off some of your spiritual merit points. A lot, big chunk. If you eat just simple food and you pay for it, and still have a lot of spiritual merit points to compensate, how would it be if you borrow something that's invisible, that you could not even pay back? So this person pretended to be nice to the master, kind, compassionate, and all that, and maybe doing this kind of sympathetic face, maybe shed a few crocodile tears. And the master said, no, you could not bear it. After he kept insisting, the master said, Jesun, Milarepa, say to him, okay, I will transfer some percent of it into this door, and then you see how powerful, how painful it can be. 1%. So he did some magic. He just waved his hand, and then the door crumbled into dust. Understand that? Yes. I wouldn't bother, because he knows that this is the person who poisoned him. Maybe he wanted to show him that he had enough power to kill him, but he didn't want to. Maybe that. But I wouldn't bother. You are dying already. What for do you have to prove it to anyone? But as I told you, habits die hard. Okay? If you have power, you cannot not use it. It's the same with governments. If you are in a powerful position, you have to really use it carefully. Very difficult. just one stroke of your pen, somebody might die, or somebody can live, something can happen to some people or some family. It's a very difficult position. That's why since time immemorial, many political figures have not fared well. Even if they want to keep themselves spotlessly clean, they're still relatives, friends, you know, or wife and husband. Now, that person who poisoned Milarepa at the end of his life went to hell forever, this kind of forever hell. Don't think only in Milarepa's time that happened. It still happens now, in my lifetime. That's why I'm telling you, I always count my blessings, that I'm still alive. That's this. Just, you know, something. But didn't take my life, okay? It's just that person is burned beyond recognition after that. But the soul, you understand, is almost destroyed. It's not about the physical body that you don't feel, you don't see it. It's the soul that's going to be destroyed. Luckily, the master has the power and can help. But that doesn't mean that person will not go to hell for a long time, at least for long, I don't know how long.